as you all know, that's the reason, part of the reason you're here. We've had reports of four different people being picked up for going over 50 kilometers an hour above the speed limit. The sad reality is it's not uncommon, and bearing well in mind, I'm sure there are a number more that have done it. These just happen to be the four that not only got caught, but the four that we've heard about here in traffic. Part of the problem that really frustrates us too is this happened during the time when we had that snowfall. So, I mean, even under ideal conditions, you know, a nice sunny day and nice tacky roads, somebody paying great attention, you're still going to take a long time to stop when you're going that much faster. So when people are going double the speed, if they think, well, I'm going to give myself double the stopping distance, that's all well and good, but you're not even going to be halfway stopped before you plow into whatever it is you think you were going to avoid. The one that was caught last night, a gentleman was going 108 down 156th Street. It's a 50 zone. Quite literally, he pulled up next to a marked police car at a red light, turned off, and then sped away at up to 108 kilometers an hour. So not only is it ridiculous to assume that he literally just saw a police car and drove away in the line of sight of this individual, but the problem comes as well. If you look up and you see a car coming at you, you're a regular Joe citizen, you're not breaking the law, and you're in an intersection, you're going to turn left. You take that snapshot and you look at the car in front of you and say, well, he's half a block away from me. I've got lots of time. Well, you would if that person's going 50 kilometers an hour, but now he's closing the distance twice as fast as you would expect. So now you're initiating the turn, and this person's plowed into the side of you when you would have expected to be long cleared through that intersection. So I guess our biggest problem is when we have people that are speeding this bad, it is quite literally the most selfish thing you can do on the roadways. Well, I shouldn't say that, of course, impaired driving being another, but it is a very selfish thing to be doing on the roadways, because the only person you are thinking about is yourself. What am I going to get into? It doesn't even consider what you might be causing. And again, if you're driving straight forward and you're thinking, well, this is all I need to worry about, I have the right of way. If you're going double the speed limit, 108 in a 50 zone, and I turn left in front of you and there's a collision, there's going to be culpability on both sides. It's not as simple as saying, well, you turned left, this isn't my fault. Quite the contrary, if somebody is going over that speed limit that much, you can very much be as much to blame for that collision.